Hey everybody, thanks for being here. This week we're on Rufus Woods Reservoir below Grand Coulee Dam for triploided rainbows. And then we're gonna go down to Baja for some yellowtail. Now if you wanna learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf and this is Angler West Television. Grand Coulee Dam on the Columbia River marks the beginning of one of the Columbia River reservoirs known as Rufus Woods Reservoir. This morning, we've launched with guide Austin Mosier to target the fast-growing and great-eating triploided trout that grow big in this 51-mile-long stretch of cold, clear water. Triploids are raised commercially for their high-quality meat, and it's these same fish that are purposely released into the lake, giving anglers a chance at some fast-paced, red-hot fishing for superior quality planter trout.
Down here, they have the fish pens, and Pacific Seafoods owns these fish pens, and they got a lot of, they're a steelhead strain of triploid, and we're going to go down here, and we're going to catch fish all around the pens, because the big fish get big from the food that they're feeding the fish inside the pens, but the food flows out of the nets, and the food that doesn't get eaten, these other fish pick up, so they're getting big and fat off the food that these guys are feeding their pen-raised fish. Triploid, they put them in a hyperbaric chamber, I think it is, and they pressurize them to like 80 degrees. And so it knocks out one of their chromosomes, so they call them triploid because they only have three chromosomes. So they don't breed. And they just grow big and get fatter and fatter every day, and they don't get the urge to breed. They must just either grow until they have a heart attack and die, or they get caught, basically.
So on these fish, like the 20-pounders, how old are they?
You know, they're not that old, 2-3 years. The guy on the pens told me that they'll grow them up to 15 pounds in a year in the pen. So I don't know how big they are when they put them in there, but they'll get up to 15 pounds in 1 year inside the pen, which is amazing.
I want to fish in the pen. Right? Do that, right? Just put me on the dock.
That's always the running joke when we're catching fish. I tell guys, oh yeah, I got a diver down there and he's got a little hatch over there and he goes over and brings them over here and hooks them up for us. So you can see the chains, the anchor chains.
Yeah.
They got one about every 60 or 70 feet on the pen. So we try to fish in between them. If you get a really big fish on, it's important to try to get him up off the bottom and keep him from running back there. Yeah, so the fish in the pens, they're raising them to sell in the stores as a food source for us, and they're contracted with the Colville tribes to release a certain amount of fish. And I've heard a lot of different numbers, but the big number I'm coming back with usually is about 50,000 fish that they're releasing per year, and that's. They're contracted to do that. So when you cast out, it's important that you don't go above the chain because it has a rope on it. There's about 8 feet of chain on it, and then there's a rope that goes all the way across underneath my boat. There's another chain right down below us. So that's your drift, basically. You want to hit pretty close to the chain and work it down. Now, your drift's going to change throughout. So if you cast the same spot every time, you're going to have the same drift every time. So I try to get people, okay, well, cast at the orange ring the next time, you know, and try to work different water if you can, and go get them. It's deep. Oh, you did it. Nice shot.
Wow.
I get guys that hit the blue ball and stuff sometimes. I got a little hoochie on here with a little power bait. Power bait gives it some scent and kind of gets it up off the bottom. We put a little bit of the Procure gel inside the hoochie skirt, which also gives it just a little bit of different type of scent, and the gel holds on a little bit better than the oil. And we got a 3-ounce cannonball to a dropper with a slider on there, which a slider is nice when you go to net a fish. If you get it stuck in the net, you don't lose the fish. So pretty typical bait setup. And that's what's been working for us. So here we go.
So next time you ought to try putting a little gel just right on the power bait.
Okay.
The cool thing with that is it's not making a mess of your hoochie.
Oh, okay.
So as your bait's wearing off, that scent's dissipating out.
Right.
Each time you put a new bait on, you can change scents and you don't have to change rigs.
Oh, that makes sense.
Okay. You know, from a tuna to a crawfish to
whatever. Right. That makes sense. I'll try that for sure.
So on this one, it's a pretty simple setup. I'm just running a little 16th ounce nightmare jig under a float, just like steelhead fishing. So that way I don't have to just sit there with the rod out in the rod holder. I can just keep fishing. Just got a little inline sinker on a slip float, and it seems to be set about 15, 16 feet. So pretty neat deal.
Back to Rufus Woods Reservoir. I'm Justin Wolf. This morning, the triploided trout are eager to take our offerings.
Aww.
But it's the smaller fish that are finding our baits first.
I thought he was a little bigger.
Sorry, didn't it look bigger, huh?
It looked bigger the way you were fighting him.
Yeah. Shut up. it's a beautiful fish. For here is a really small fish, but really, they're great size. They're just, they've been catching a little bit bigger ones this year, but this is a great size fish. It's a beautiful fish.
Yeah, so we get some really large fish in the area, and the biggest one we got so far in my boat was 20 pounds. I think we've had three or four other fish that were in that 15 to 17 pound range, which is a pretty awesome fish. That was a nice one, just jumped right there. You see that? So, these are a little bit smaller, fun to catch, good to eat. But, you know, we're kind of looking for something just a little bit bigger.
We're below Cooley Dam, and a lot of times they'll dump water, and the current speeds will pick up, and we got slots here that we got to cast between because there's some chains coming off the pins. And a lot of times we have to, you want your stuff to get down quick and be in the strike zone longer. So what I did is I upped the amount of lead, and then that'll allow me to get down faster and be in the strike zone a little longer.
Got one on in the front too.
Oh, Jason's got one. Gretchen's got one. Double. Please miss one. Feel like a better fish?
It was okay. Came off.
Come off right there. Oh no. That one was about 5 pounds.
It worked going a little heavier on the lead and getting down faster, so hopefully the success continues.
What do we got? Are we going to need the big net, Steve?
I don't think so. just a practice.
Oh, no. So here's the deal. I almost had him. It was close. So the deal is they've released about 30,000 of those fish is kind of the numbers people are telling me. And they just released them about 5 days ago. And so we are plagued with a lot of small fish just in the last few days. All winter long, big fish averaging 8 to 10 pounds. And now we're dealing with the smaller fish, which is a good problem to have, a lot of fish, but at the same time, we're looking for the big ones, right?
And it doesn't take long.
Oh, you missed it. Yep, so we'll get this one baited up and back out.
Cool.
You know, the yellow and green colors have been working really well. When I put the power bait on here, I try to leave the hook exposed a little bit, so that way when they pick it up, it's right there. But yellows, greens have kind of been the ticket this year. Chartreuse, there's one called Spring Green that was really good. Chartreuses seem to work better in the last couple weeks than the greens, and I haven't had great luck with pinks and things like that. Catch a few on orange, but mostly just green and chartreuse. Typical stuff.
I think they're beautiful.
Pretty fish.
You need the bigger net for this one.
Nice fish.
Beautiful.
Look at that, the sun. Got a mag lip on this rod here. Put a little dropper weight on it to get it down. And we just got bit. He didn't stick around, but he hit it. He came back for it. And I think we got him this time. Mag lip 3.0. Good old boy color. And we got a little trout on our head. Trout love mag lips, that's for sure. Yep, another little fish. Mag lip strikes again. We're gonna work on looking for a little bigger one. We're gonna let this one go.
Woohoo, I'll be done here in about 2 seconds. Pretty
thick. Yeah, I got it right here.
Oh, another whopper.
Yeah.
Catching all the big ones already, Steve.
Sorry.
The Triploid trout fishery in Rufus Woods Reservoir is hard to beat for planter trout. And today we're catching them on everything we throw, including hoochies and bait, jigs, mag lips, and other plugs. And sometimes it's the simple little modifications to your presentation that can make a big difference.
All right. Get right on that little hoochie. What were you putting on there for scent?
That had anise bloody tuna.
Anise bloody tuna, huh?
Yes, sir.
Seemed to work. Nice job.
Perfect size for eating.
Yeah. Get a little smoker fish or barbecue them up. Good eating.
So, Austin, do you have a little, what is it, just a float inside the hoochie?
Got a little pill float in there.
Right on.
And if the bait comes off, the pill float will keep it up off the bottom so that it doesn't get hung up, basically.
And it keeps it full.
Gives a little more buoyancy. Yeah.
It looks more pretty in the water.
Right.
I'm going to say it's bigger.
Yeah, are you? Oh, yeah. It's all right.
Not a bad one. Just a tiny bit bigger.
Bring him up the side of the boat, not the back for me. I can net him right over here.
He wants
the back. There you go. Nice. That's a little bit better one.
I know.
Be a good eater. Triploids are great eating.
Yay.
Good job.
All righty.
Woohoo. Part of it.
Go, Steve.
Double.
Double trouble. Oh, he unwrapped himself. Good job, fish.
Yes, sir. Woohoo!
Is it a whopper?
About the same as I've been catching all day. Pretty fish. Well, no bait, they can go back.
Oh, that's nice, Ed.
Yeah.
Not bad.
This is just a hoochie with no bait and just twitched it in the water. Picked it right up.
That's a good old boy.
Hi.
Well.
So this is a Neil's Master plug that I brought. For something different. Not many places to buy them here in town. Let's see. Find something new. Does a great job of getting tail on the other rod.
Yeah. Yeah, and since we're catching that fish on one of these plugs, we can go ahead and release it. We're not using bait, so we can try to weed through some of these smaller fish to get some bigger ones.
Nice.
Yeah. Not to say that that's a real small fish. That's a pretty nice fish.
Yeah, for a lot of places, this is huge.
Yeah.
But according to the pictures you've been sending on Facebook recently, yeah.
Yep, so I'll try to we'll try to leave him in the water and I'll get the pliers here.
They're off and get bigger.
There he goes.
Perfect.
Bye-bye. So that looks like a great color. Steve brought these plugs and I was kind of looking through them and that's kind of the color that they're liking, that green chartreuse with like a dark back. You know, a lot of our jigs are black and pink and our power bait's been chartreuse, so looks like a great color for here.
Working.
To get the plug down to the bottom, we're in about 30 feet of water right here, and to get that plug down to the bottom, we put a dropper with a slinky weight on it, and the slinky weight will help us to not get tangled up on the bottom or get snagged up. So that's basically getting it down into the strike zone and putting that lure right in the fish's face that are down near the bottom.
It's a beautiful, typical sunrise over the East Cape of Baja, where we're fishing out of the Hotel Palmas de Cortez in the town of Los Barriles, which is about an hour's drive from Cabo San Lucas. It's late February, which is considered the off-season for fishing, but the action for winter species such as yellowtail can be fantastic. We're towards the end of the run for yellowtail in this area, but with any luck, we should be able to hook up. We're with Jimmy Diaz and his two daughters, Amy and Frida. Jimmy owns and operates both Can-Do Rentals and the Can-Do Restaurant in Los Barriles, and is an avid fisherman. We're running to Sorabo Island, which acts as the gateway to the Gulf of California, that all migrating fish must pass by. Its official name is actually Jacques Cousteau Island, named after the famous French underwater explorer, who called this area the Aquarium of the World. The clear, fertile water is home to incredible numbers of fish species, such as the sardines, that provide a food base for the larger predatory species, such as yellowtail. With a live well full of bait, it's time to go fishing.
Okay, we made it. We're to the spot. Never been this far before, this side of the island. This is kind of cool. Obviously, when you see the other boats here, you know you've come to the right spot, hopefully. So we're gonna put some live bait down, and I'll probably work some iron and see what's happening. This is gonna be fun. So you're spraying water to try to mimic the bait, try to bring the fish up. I've never seen them do that down here before. I've seen other places, but
first time.
Our live baits out and some occasional chumming to draw the fish in, it didn't take long to get our first hookup. But not with the target species. Frida has caught a bonito, which is a fun little fish, but not the yellowtail that we're after.
Looks like Jimmy's got her first hookup here.
All right.
I don't think this is a bonito. We caught a bonito first, but now I think, or it's a big bonito. The yellowtail or a jack, they're the yellowtail amberjack is what their full name is. Lots of fish called yellowtail. The yellowtail amberjack is what we're catching here. It's a white-meated fish. It's not tuna. Some people call them tuna, but they're not a tuna. But they're still really good eating. Fun to catch, and I think we got one here. Oh. It's another bonita. Right on.
Yeah.
These are striped bonito, which are common in this area and are considered good eating. There are several other species, such as black skipjack, skipjack tuna, and Pacific bonito that look similar, but aren't considered a quality food fish. If you see the captain flaying your catch, you know you've caught the right one. This is a black skipjack that fell for a fish field jig. These grow fairly large and are great fun as a catch and release species.
Right. Jimmy's hooked up out here. You're using live bait though, right? You
drop a jig.
A jig? Oh, right on. Got a jig fish. Cool. Another.
Pretty good.
Yeah. Well, it's another bonito. But you like eating these, don't you?
This one is very good to eat.
Yeah.
Good for sashimi.
Oh, yeah. There he is. Captain made a big turn. The fish came right at me. I thought I lost it for a second. But yeah, we got, this is definitely a yellowtail. There he goes. we're doing is live bait. We're fly lining live sardines. I did get... There he goes. Just gonna let him run. But you know, earlier I was jigging these spro jigs and I hit that too. My capitano wanted me to switch to live bait. So when the fishing's slow, you don't argue with the captain, you know? Yeah. I don't have a cushion. My cushion, I forgot to bring one. They usually have them on the boat here.
Yeah. No tienen la.
Oh, they got a cushion. Oh, it's like, that'll get you. That's no fun in your belly.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, here we go. Now we're talking.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Now we go. Think this is a particularly big one. You know, these are it's a yellowtail amberjack, right? Yeah. That's what it really is. It's in the jack family, like a rooster fish or a jack crevalle or an amberjack. So they're strong, but I don't think this guy is real big. Fish right there, perfect eating fish. We like that, huh? Bueno.
Yeah.
We ended up with one yellowtail and lots of bonita and skipjack on this trip. But the great thing about fishing in Baja is that it's not always about catching lots of fish. In later months, you might load the boat with yellowfin tuna, catch a 50-pound rooster fish, or get double hookups on marlin. But there's really no bad time to fish the Baja. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, there wouldn't be no show. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.